Hey, you want to take the controls?
Okay. The flight controls.
Hey, you have the controls, and we're pretty much level here, so go ahead and lift the hover. The brakes are off, and we're all set to go.
Okay, coming up.
001, hover. Everything's trimmed up for hover. That's where the controls trim, but you'll have to adjust it for the winds.
Thank you.
a little bit on these pull-ups. Okay, there's 120, push over. And about a 2G recovery, 2.1. You can see how fast it rolls.
I know, my head bumped the rail.
Yeah. And we got below 80 knots, so the LFE reset the rotor. But if you look up at your G-meter there, the number on the bottom is the...
Thank you.
phenomenal. Coming left again.
Okay.
And then back right.
Okay.
Clear right.
We got 1,000. Sub 15. There's 18, 19, there's 10,000.
That's a far cry from not being able to go vertical.
Yeah.
Okay, and on the mark, I'll be pushing over 3, 2, 1, mark.
I need to do. I don't see what those that barber polling would, why it would be a problem.
Yeah, it's just a quality thing that I think. See, there's a bank and there's nothing. No.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. And we're getting. Yeah, it's a low fuel, so we'll finish it up with a running landing.
Okay. Yeah, I'm seeing shadows and.
Running landing's kind of a handful because the gear, the way the gear is right now. But I'll just kind of talk through what I'm doing.
Okay.
If you don't have a strong neck, you can get hurt with the agility that this thing can provide.
Yes, too.
Russ, thank goodness, calmed down 3, 2, 1. And, the first one I wasn't really ready for. Felt like I almost put my head out the window. So extremely agile. I felt very safe, very comfortable. It's a very well orchestrated event. You know, the aircraft has just got so much capability. I had to make a transition initially from trying to overfly it. If you just let the systems work for you, everything turns out better. Told me a few times, you know, quit trying to control the yaw. The aircraft would do it for you, and it did. I still was working the footrests, couldn't make that stop. I don't know if that would ever go away. Never felt scared, always felt safe. I was amazed at how smooth everything was. Vibrations. You know, there really are some cues that you get from certain vibrations. I wasn't getting those. So you start looking and grasping for other areas to cue them. You know, one of the biggest concerns I had in the desert was not the ZSU shooting on me, but that one guy with the AK. You know, I feel very confident that with the ability of this thing to snap around, how quick it can turn, move around, you can honestly say you can avoid fire from that guy. And I'm not saying it's Superman bulletproof, but just absolutely phenomenal. When you see something, how incredibly quick you can snap and turn away from it and you're gone. Just that fast. And you can't do that in the Apache. You can't do that in any helicopter that I've flown in the Army.